If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today, we're going to start implementing the next package or plugin within our Filament package series. What I want to work on today is adding a signature pad for users. To get us started, before we even take a look at the plugin, I want to add a signature field to the admin on the edit user page, or, you know, it doesn't really matter, but anything that displays the specific user, that's where I want the signature pad to go. So let's go ahead and add that signature field to these users. In our text editor, I just want to open up the terminal. Let's go ahead and create that migration. I'm just going to call it add signature field to users table. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at that. It's right down here at the bottom since it's the newest. So in here, we can go ahead and do table. It'll be a text field because the package that we're going to be using, it converts the signature to an SVG or a picture file. So we can go ahead and just create it as a text field. We'll put it after the isActive field in our database. And we should also probably make it nullable so that not every user is going to want to put their signature. So we can just leave this as nullable. And then we need to drop the table. So that if, for whatever reason, if we run, let's say, a fresh flag on our migrations and it just drops all our tables and puts them back up, we want to make sure that this column also gets dropped and brought back up. Let's go ahead and add this to the user model. This way it can be added to the user model, no problem. Let's go ahead and migrate. We're not really going to see anything just yet, so let's go and grab our package. Here in the Filament documentation, if you go to the plugins tab and then head down, we're going to go ahead and do a search for signature. This pulls up a package by Samson Mausa. We'll go ahead and click that. And as you can see, this is pretty much what we're getting. We have a little box, which is going to be our text field. You can clear it. You can download it as an SVG, PNG, JPG. These are all image files. And that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead to the GitHub repository. And if we head down, we can start checking out the instructions for this. We'll go ahead and grab this. And then we'll do that command right in there. Go ahead, press enter, let it run. Great, let's follow the next step. Here we can go ahead and scroll down and take a look. And this is basically how you would bring it into your resource. You can also set different options such as stroke, min width, you know, just whatever stroke is going to look like. You can set different things there, as well as the pen color and the background color. And this is just, you know, the RGB 4004 blue, and this is for black transparent. Okay, and then this is what it's going to look like if you were to do stuff like that. And that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead and try to bring this into our user model or resource. Go ahead up to the form, and why don't we just put it under the name for right now. Okay, go ahead and import it, and we can actually close these up now. We're not going to need them, and that should be good. So let's go and check the browser and see what happens. Look at that, we have an error. This isn't the type of error that says we did anything wrong. This is just saying that there is a variable somewhere in our package that this is not exactly what it is. Right? In researching this plugin, I found out that this is a problem within the plugin itself. So let's go and see where this is located. I'm going to close this out, and we can close this out as well. If we head all the way down to our vendor folder, and the name of our plugin is Savannah Bits Filament Signature Pad, this is actually coming from the source forms components signature pad. It is using the has signature pad attributes. It is a trait within this folder right here. So if we go down, take a look at it, and open it up. Now, this is a list of different functions. This is where it's getting the options for the stroke, the pen color, all the things that we just looked at for options, that's what's in this file right here. And if you go all the way down to the bottom, you see we have isDisableDownload as a function that isn't really a working function. It's better to say that it works. It's just the wrong name for this function, right? Something along maybe when something was upgraded or updated within the package itself, this was never checked, was never tested. And this is a perfect example of having too many packages in your project and something breaks like this and then you have to go hunt it down. Right? So one of the things that I really want to stress with this entire series is that this could happen. If we look at the repo, you see that the repo was actually updated March 2nd. If we take a look, it says plus one release, and then nothing about that function is listed at all. If you go to the issues and the pull requests, a lot of people have asked this user, are you going to update it or not? We'll take a look at the pull request and see what's going on in here. Someone has said, function name is disabled download, not is download disabled. You know, this is basically the suggestion. However, I always stress, even if you're going to use one package, a ton of packages, whatever, to build out your project, never ever do this in the vendor folder. So let's go and see how we can work around this issue so that if you ever do update the package and it is working appropriately, you're not ruining your project. The first thing that I want to do is, this is just really a trait, right? And where do we put our traits? Well, we put them in the app folder. We create a folder called traits, and that's where we put our traits within our project. So I'm going to copy this file. I'm going to go all the way to the app folder up here. I'm going to create a new folder called traits. And then I'm just going to paste this in here so that we have the exact same file, but I am going to change the namespace. So now here we can go down to the bottom and now we can change it in our new custom trait. So instead of is disabled download, we'll do is download disabled. That's good here. Now the other part of it is if we take a look at the user resource and we have our class of signature pad down here, but when we imported it, it was from the signature pad forms components fields. Slash signature pad. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy this from the vendor folder, and then we could point it to that trait. So we'll go ahead, grab it. And I'm going to just copy this folder here. And then we're going to go all the way up. And since we're using this for our resources, I'm just going to go ahead and paste it within the resources folder. So now we have fields. Actually, I wanted to grab the whole thing. Go ahead and grab the whole thing. It is components. I'll grab it from here. And hopefully this should be the whole thing. Components field signature pad. So now in this signature pad file that we have, we can now change it from here so that we can point it to our actual trait. So we'll just use that from our custom trait. And we also need to change the namespace here from app filament resources. And then we can get rid of the rest of this. And that's the entire namespace. So now let's go ahead to this user resource. And now instead of importing this one that we used originally, we can now use our new one, which is the app filament resources, blah, 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 blah. Let's go and see if we're still getting that error. We're no longer seeing it. And we have our pad in here. So something we can do is something like this, right? Because I write like a four-year-old. And you can clear it, as you saw. You can also download it as an SVG, PNG, JPG. As I said, it will be used as a picture file or a picture string. So then we'll go down and we'll save changes. That's saved. Let's go and take a look at it. And there we go. That's my signature, right? Or as close to it as I can get. And if we look at the database, we should be able to refresh it, go to the users table. And now you see we have a text field. And if we open that up, you can see when I hover, you see the entire data string of it. That's pretty much all there is to it. And it's an entire string, so it's sort of cleansed the file for us as well. We're almost done with our series. I have one more package left to do. I don't know if it's going to go up next week. It might go up the week after. No idea. But make sure you're subbed and turn your notifications on, and you'll know as soon as it goes live. And the good thing about doing it this way and just having it go to the database is that you don't actually have to store it within your project. You know, you wouldn't have to store it in a storage file. That's probably not a secure thing to do anyway, so that's just what it is. If you're enjoying the content, please click that like button as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.